Welcome to week 9, where we are going to discuss marine life. In this particular video, we're going to get into what specifically a marine organism is and some of the types of organisms that inhabit the oceans. And then we'll start in on how we classify organisms, and in video 2, we'll continue with the classification of organisms. And then in video 3, we'll discuss some of the conditions that these marine organisms adapt to. So what is a marine organism? Pretty simple. It's an organism, plant, animal, that spends a majority of its life in the ocean. So things like seals, whales, sea stars, things of that nature. So the different types of organisms that inhabit the oceans, we group these in different ways based on what they look like, their structure, or what's called taxonomy, which we're going to go into in this video. They're also divided up into different categories based on their habitat or where they live, and then their behavior in relationship to one another. So we'll go over habitat and behavior in the next video. So some types of organisms that we see, some of the most common ones that you notice when you go to the coast are those organisms that live in tide pools, like mussels, sea stars, seaweed, seals, whales, things that live out in the open ocean as well. So, to talk about how we classify these organisms based on their structure, what we can do is break them into different kingdoms. So, these different kingdoms are very specific as to kind of what fits into each one. And then each kingdom is divided up into smaller subsections, going from very wide categories, so broad, very different organisms all in one kingdom, all the way down to phylum, class, order, family, genus, and species is a very, very specific group. So we are in the species Homo sapien, whereas something like a canine wouldn't be in the same species, a dog. So, but we would be all in the same kingdom. So we're in one larger group together, but once we get into that finer detail, based on our structure, what we look like, how we're kind of put together, splits us up into different species once we get further on down the line. So it's just kind of a reminder from high school biology. So the major kingdoms that we have are bacteria and archaea, protista, fungi, plant, and animalia. So to get into the specifics, bacteria and archaea, these are single-celled organisms. They lack a cell nucleus, and they reproduce asexually. So these are very, very small, microscopic type things. When we get into the next one, protista, these are also single-celled organisms. They do have a cell nucleus, which is what makes them different from the bacteria and archaea kingdoms, and they also reproduce asexually. And these can also be pretty small. Most of these are going to be microscopic as well. Some of them can be a bit larger. Fungi, so we're getting to things that hopefully you might recognize. So if you were out hiking in the woods, or you go out to dinner and you have mushrooms on your plate, or you see a mushroom in the woods, these are part of the kingdom fungi. And these are multicellular organisms. They consume external sources of food, and they reproduce mainly by spores. Good example are, again, mushrooms. Plants that are around you, so algae, seeded plants, trees, grass, these are single and multicellular organisms. So we have two different sized organisms here, and they are going to be producing their own food from inorganic compounds through photosynthesis, so using the sun to help them live and survive and produce their own food. And the last category is animalia. And these are multicellular organisms that consume external sources of food and move in response to external stimulation. So us, we're in this kingdom, animalia. Birds, sea stars, worms, fish are all in this larger category of animalia. We can divide it up into vertebrates or invertebrates. So the difference between these two is vertebrates have a spinal cord and backbone. Invertebrates do not. So worms, sponges, arthropods, these are critters that don't have a solid backbone, whereas vertebrates like mammals, reptiles, fish, birds all have a solid backbone. So these are the different categories based on what an organism looks like. So that goes over what marine organisms are and dividing up our organisms based on what they look like. We'll come back in the next video and talk about some of the other ways of categorizing these marine organisms.